Drill it. Welcome back. I'm David the Good. For some time, I've been making biochar and adding it to my soil. We've seen some very good results so far, enough so that I thought, hey, this may be the answer to my soil fertility issues. However, I haven't crushed much of my biochar because it's a pain in the neck. Instead, I just made charcoal from a lot of smaller sticks, and then I soaked it in barrels of Dave's fetid swamp water, along with a few shots of DynaGrow Grow liquid fertilizer to catch any nutrients I might have missed. This soaking period charges the biochar, allowing it to soak up minerals before it's added to the soil. If you don't charge it, the biochar will soak up the fertility of your soil for a year or more before finding balance. I would rather have it preloaded with nutrients so it acts as a battery in the soil, giving the plant roots what they need right away. If biochar is ground to a smaller size, the surface area increases, and it may be more useful as a soil amendment. Smashing it with a hammer or running it over with a car is a pain, so I set out in search of a better way to grind it. Then I came across Herrick Kimball's video.
Hello, my name is Herrick Kimball. I am the author of the Planet Whiz Bang idea book for gardeners, and today I'm going to show you an idea that is in this book.
He uses a garbage disposal to grind his biochar. Anyone who has read my books or watched my videos for a while knows that I am a big fan of Herrick Kimball's work, and I was not surprised to find that he'd found an easier solution to the biochar grinding problem. However, as I considered his method, I thought, hey, why not combine the grinding and the charging processes together? Since I literally wrote an entire book on composting, Compost Everything, The Good Guide to Extreme Composting, making compost is a big part of my life. And a garbage disposal is a great way to chew up kitchen scraps so they break down quickly. provided you're not flushing it down your drain, because that's a total waste. So my second-born son and I built a biochar and compost grinder table that fits on a pair of sawhorses. The whole thing cost about $100. For the build, we used scrap lumber, a large cutting board from Walmart, a light switch from Ace Hardware, a Waste King quarter horsepower garbage disposal off Amazon, and some sawhorse joints from Marvin's Hardware. We put the thing together and we added the light switch to the side, which allows us to turn it off and on. I've dubbed the machine the Compochar Buffemerator Mark I. It took about a day to build. How to operate your new Compochar Buffemerator Mark I. Since a waste disposal like this requires water to run properly, I decided to use water from my pond so I didn't have any chlorine in it. I charged it with manure tea, urine, some C90 sea salt, and a generous shot of Dynagro for extra nutrients. Then I took a big bucket of kitchen scraps and another bucket of biochar chunks, and I started grinding. Beneath my table is a 5-gallon bucket which catches the resulting black slop. As I had hoped, it worked, and it's a lot of fun to operate. The charcoal grinds down quite fine along with the food scraps, and the two can now compost together. For this first round, I'm just putting lids on the buckets of char slop when they're finished and putting them aside to ferment for a couple of weeks. However, there are a lot of things that could be done with this method. I could grind all the materials and pour the buckets into a larger barrel and run an aquarium pump so it all stays aerobic and breeds more beneficial bacteria. Or I could pour the material into my worm bin and let the worms work their way through it. Or I could just take the buckets of char slop and pour them into my compost pile, or even right into my garden. This is just the beginning of the experiment, but I thought you all would appreciate the system we built. I'll put links to all the pieces and their costs in the video description. Thanks for watching. Stick around for more gardening inspiration, and be sure to like and subscribe and hit the bell so you catch my future videos. See y'all next time, and until then, may your thumbs always be green.
I went to see David. David the Good. We listened to Portishead and drank spiced rum.